Ciao friends, I have a new DAX puzzle for you. It is a model where we have three tables and two measures, a few relationships. The puzzle is, what is the result of the all tokens measure in the table that you see here? So take your time, think of the solution, and in a few seconds I will provide the solution. So first pose, are you ready? Okay, let's go. So what happens here? When we have this situation, we have a let's start with the tokens measure. The count rows tokens works this way. We have, for example, in the first row, we have A selected here, which means that we have in the filter context, a filter for A in the name column. And the presence of this filter filters associations, because we have A that filters T1, T4, T5. And the filter, because of the bidirectional filter, the filter propagates two tokens, T1, T4, T5. For this reason, count rows of tokens produces the result of 3 that you see here. Now, what happens when we execute the same measure applying in the filter context this all tokens filter modifier? Well, all tokens removes the filter from the expanded table tokens. The expanded table tokens is only this one. We don't have a many-to-one relationship from tokens to other tables. And so this means that the filter that we have in name is still there. When we execute all tokens, we get as a result exactly the same result that we had for tokens, because these all tokens will remove only filters applied to the tokens table. So we have 3, 2, 1, and 5. Result of all tokens is identical to tokens in this example. So this is the solution of the puzzle. Now you probably say, wait a minute, but all should remove all the filters, should return the entire table. Well, all used as a filter modifier in calculate removes the filters, but if we use all as a table function, the result is different. So let's take a look at this example. Here we have all tokens 2, which is a count rows of all tokens. In this case, all tokens is a table function. As a table function, it always retrieves the entire content of the tokens table, and so the result is 5, 5, 5, 5, no matter what, because in this case the filter context is totally ignored. What if we want to obtain a calculate using all, removing the filters also from the other table that could affect tokens in an indirect way because of bidirectional filter? This is what we can do using all cross filter. If we use all cross filter, what happens? All cross filters remove the filter from tokens, from associations, and from names. Which means that if I repeat the same exercise I did before, so I have a filter context here with just A, which is the filter for the column name here. At this point, when I execute here my calculate with all cross filter removes the filter here, here, and here. Now, without this filter, the result of the table tokens is the entire table. So, if I use this version here, all cross filter tokens, I will still get 5, 5, 5, 5. Now, as you see, the important lesson here is that all used as a filter modifier has a different behavior than all used as a table function. And for this reason, we suggest to not use all in calculate. Now, we have a specific function that makes it clear what is the purpose of the filter modifier, and this function is called remove filters. It has exactly the same parameters, the same behavior. Let me write it. It has the same behavior of all, but it can be used only in calculate. And this way, when you read the code, you immediately realize I'm just removing the filter, so relationships are important, or I'm getting the entire table no matter what. So I hope that you like this DAX puzzle. In any case, enjoy DAX.